Gene Legan, who'll be with me at ringside tonight. A lot of exciting matches today. We'll be seeing the American Bulldogs in action. Gene, I don't know about you, but they have made one whale of an impression on me.
Two rough characters, very strong individuals.
No doubt about it. It's not just the power, but the speed and the finesse in which they operate with. And I'll tell you what, I spoke to them, and Spike and Rex have told me they've got their eyes on that tournament that's coming up for the North American Wrestling Association Tag Team title. Bob Orton Jr., Vince Torelli, and of course, everybody's Mr. All-America, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat's going to be in action tonight. You know an awful lot about Ricky. What can you say about him that hasn't been said?
There's not much you can say. A man's got all the package. He's got wrestling ability, strength, size. He's got quickness. He's got everything.
I tell you what, he's got the careful eye of Cowboy Bob Orton and a host of others who have already expressed an interest in taking on Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, because as well as the tag team combination tournament, we're also going to be seeing that heavyweight championship tournament coming up in the very near future. And of course, if they can beat Ricky, it serves also as a psychological ploy to let Ricky know that they can't beat him. So we're in for one great exciting night of action. Stick with us. Right now, let's turn it over to our ring announcer, Fabian Fuentes.
This next match is a one fall with a 10-minute time limit tag team action. In the ring at this time, weighing 225 pounds from West Palm Beach, Florida, Jerry Rose. His partner, weighing in at 247 pounds, from North Chicago, Rick Slagy. And now, making their way to the ring, weighing a combined 550 pounds, here are Rex and Spike, the American Bulldogs.
Well, you heard the introductions from Fabian Fuentes, the American Bulldogs, in a tag team match, an Australian tag team match against Jerry Rose and Rick Slagle, and this promises to be an exciting match. I'll tell you what, I love these guys. I've seen them in action, Gene, and I'll tell you what, they are tough, they are smooth, they are just simply fantastic.
A very confident team, a lot of quickness, a lot of size. When you can get quickness and size together, you have got an unbeatable team.
No doubt about it. The referee for this event will be Byron Richard, and he's trying to get all of the combatants organized right now so that we can ring the bell and get underway. There is the signal. The bell has rung, and we are underway. Rick Slagle into the ring against the man they call Rex. Rex and Spike, the British Bulldogs. We're ringside in Raleigh, North Carolina. Ted Webb and Gene Legan, and this is the best in professional wrestling, the North American Wrestling Association. Side headlock by the American Bulldog. Great takedown. These guys can wrestle too, Coach.
Yes, sir. A tremendous maneuver. He's letting Rick Slagle know right now that he can wrestle.
You know, a lot of people might say, what a chicken this Slagle is going outside the ring, but in all honesty, it's a smart maneuver. If he feels he's in trouble, he's got to get out of there and get his thoughts in order and reorganize before he goes back in.
A very smart maneuver. He had a different idea in his mind when he got in that ring. He found out right quick that this is not going to be an easy night.
Twisting that wrist, makes the tag into the ring is Spike. Actually, Rex. Hard for me to tell. Oh, my Lord. Working on that elbow. This is Spike who is in the ring. That's hard for me to tell them apart. They're brothers.
They look like twins.
Almost. They could pass as twins. The American Pit Bulls. They are fresh from a successful tour of New Zealand and also the Orient. And boy, they're anxious to take on all comers in the North American Wrestling Association. Gene Legan, we're getting people from all over the world that want to come and wrestle here. Now, that was a maneuver that went astray, trying to reverse it. Nice hip hop takedown. Listen to this crack.
The speed of these young men is unbelievable.
Yeah, I noticed Jerry Rose, and there is no desire for Jerry Rose to make the tag. Normally, when your partner's in trouble, look at Rose. Rose is looking into the audience. He doesn't want any part of this.
Jerry Rose is hoping there's no rope there for him to hold on to.
Tag had been made, and I'm sure that Slagle didn't note it. In for the cover. One, two, powering out is Slagle. You know, the thing that you notice about these guys is the fluid movement of them. They're fresh. They're in and out of the ring, in and out of the ring. You can see that these guys have been wrestling together for an awful long time.
That's what tag team wrestling is all about, tagging in, tagging out, making sure that it's like two men on one at all times. a fresh man in the ring at all times.
That is Rex in the ring right now against Slagle. Slagle in the right. Ooh. Nice elbow to the back of the head. Slagle outsmarted him that time. Has him up for a body slam. Going for the cover, but he doesn't have those legs hooked, Gene.
Slagle's got to remember to hook the legs. He's also got to remember that this young man here is very strong. He needs to tag out himself.
Firing away, Slagle now, trying to turn the tide, trying to get Mo on his side. Big momentum. And I still see no act of Jerry Rose showing desire. He makes the tag, but that was kind of a lackluster tag. Boot to the side of the stomach. Picking him up for a body slam. Boom! Down in the square of the back, and now Jerry Rose! Jerry Rose underestimating the American Pit Bulls.
Working together as usual, the Bulldogs tagging in and tagging out. One trouble, Logan comes in.
Nice boot to the side of the head as the Bulldogs. The Bulldogs are starting to show that teamwork. Coming down on the side of the throat. And I'll tell you what, Jerry Rose right now is going to be in a bigger hurry to tag out than he was to tag in.
You see how the Bulldogs are firing themselves up. Their self-motivation, that's what makes them a difference between a champion and a loser.
You saw him communicating to his partner. Boom, drop kick. Talking to each other in the ring, Gene.
You've got to act as one in this wrestling match.
Nice to play. This could be it for Jerry Rose. I tell you what, if the Bulldogs want to put an end to it right now, they can. One, two, but that leg is on the ring ropes, and the referee, Byron Richard, calling for the break.
Jerry Rose is trying every minute he can think of just to survive.
No doubt about it. No. Jerry Rose right now in trouble. Much the worse for wear. Caught in the stomach. This time they surprised him. He was expecting that drop kick that they gave him a few seconds ago. Getting him up on that pile driver. He's, oh no, oh no. What would you call that, Gene?
That looked like a pancake or a flapjack or something.
A sugar hole, as good Paul Jones would call it. They do some maneuvers that you don't see often. Snap air takedown. Bouncing off the rope. This is Spike landing on that throat to that knee. And this could be it for Jerry Rose, the cat of two and three. And that, nope. Byron Richard said it was only two. Boy, that was close.
Yeah, he went for the three count, but the shoulder came up just in time.
I'll tell you what, that's when it's tough to be an official in any sport. To me, it looked like a three count. They got him in there for that double rowboat. Boy, that splits the groin muscles. And I'll tell you what, some of these groin injuries take months sometimes to heal.
The wrestlers have to keep their flexibility as much as possible, but weightlifters tend to get a little tight. And Jerry Rose, I know, is not as flexible as he'd like to be.
That was a variation of the souple, that double chicken wing souple. This is Rex, who was in the ring. Rex of the American Bulldogs making the tag. Spike now enters the ring. Let's see what they got cooked up this time. Uh-oh. Boom! That's that track block in football.
That's right, a blindside. Blindside him real good. He didn't even see him coming.
He didn't even see him coming in football. They'd call that a trap block. Spike now firing away. Jerry Rose trying to make the tag with Rick Slagle. Rose's legs right now are wobbly, Gene. Boom! That hurts. That neck landed on the top ring rope. And I'll tell you what, you talk about possible damage to the larynx. What it does temporarily is cut off that supply of oxygen.
It can take your voice out. It can take your wind out. You can't breathe. You can't wrestle. You've got to have oxygen. That's your fuel.
That was a mistake there on the part of the American Bulldogs because he allowed him to make the tag with a fresh Rick Slagle when it appeared that Rose was hurt. Nice leg dive takedown.
Drop toe hold there. He's got him in a front face lock right now.
Referee Byron Richard, of course, has his hands cut, his hands full, his work cut out for him with these two teams in the ring because both guys can go downtown, Gene. Let's face it. We've got four tough competitors in the ring right now. Notice how Slagle didn't want any more of it. Tagged out with a very tired Jerry Rose. Rose up for a full body slam. Boom!
Well, Slagle is taking care of himself. That is not his normal partner in wrestling, and he's definitely not feeling sorry for Jerry Rose right
not
now.
Not at all. He's seen enough of the American Bulldogs tonight. Boom! Forearm to the throat. Jerry Rose, this time he split them over. Two, three, and that is it. This match belongs to the American Bulldogs, Spike and Rex. And listen to this crowd. There the Bulldogs' arms are raised in victory by Byron Richard. Let's take a look at the slow motion instant replay, Gene, and tell us exactly what happened.
Well, here it comes off. He's going to arm whip him to the rope. He runs over and grabs his partner and slingshots him through the air. That's a good 6 feet in the air he brought him over. Caught him right in the jaw. That's a 1-2-3 count right there.
And this one belongs to the American Bulldogs. And we don't want you to go away because there's a lot more action coming up on the North American Wrestling Association. Coming up next, Brad Anderson and Colt Steele against Brian Johnson and David Eisley.
The ball to my right, weighing 235 pounds from Wilmington, North Carolina, Brian Johnson. His partner this evening, weighing 230 pounds from Charlotte, North Carolina, David Eisley. Their opponents tonight to my left, weighing 250 pounds from Minnesota, Brad Anderson. His partner, weighing 252 pounds from Venice Beach, California, Colt Steele.
Well, I'll tell you what, he has forgotten all of his Carolina roots. We all know he was from Rayford, North Carolina, and then after hanging around with Ivan Koloff, he decided to move out to Venice Beach, Gene, and I tell you what, Carolinians said, go. We don't want you.
That's right, Colt Steele. I know he's been from Rayford, North Carolina all his life, and here he is now from Venice Beach, California.
Well, he's hanging out with that crowd. Might as well say that he's from there, because they don't claim him here in the Carolinas. David Eisley into the ring against Colt Steele. Colt Steele was an outstanding college linebacker and a guy that could have made a career in the National Football League, but opted for pro wrestling, his first love.
That's right, Carolina's own David Eisley.
The Carolina connection, David Eisley and Brian Johnson. Brad Anderson, unmasked by War Eagle. He was the Viper, and War Eagle unmasked him. And here he is teaming up with Colt Steele. They say that birds of a feather flock together. And tonight is certainly proof of that. Collar and elbow. Both men testing each other for leverage and strength. Into the turnbuckles. Your referee for this match, Ron West, calling for the break. And Colt Steele hammering away with those knees to the midsection. Nice reversal into the turnbuckle. Pitch and bouncing off. The tag is made and into the ring. Into the ring right now. Brad Anderson. Anderson is a good wrestler.
Excellent wrestler, comes from a great background. Of course, David Eisley caught him with an arm drag right there.
Come on, Dave. Brad Anderson from Minnesota, a state that has produced so many outstanding wrestlers.
Come on, Dave.
He's from that Anderson clan, you know.
The Anderson clan, he has a great heritage to live up to.
Nice move by Eisley, who tags out with Brian Johnson. Anderson may have hurt his shoulders on the turnbuckle that time. Going into that safe corner. Going to talk it over with his partner, Colt Steele. Let's see if Brian Johnson goes for that shoulder, which he apparently hurt going into the turnbuckle.
He does. Brian Johnson get a hammerlock on Brad Anderson. Tightening up very nicely.
Nice reversal.
Nice reversal. As is she the wrestling from the Anderson family.
Tag is made, and into the ring comes Colt Steele. Wearing the lime green trunks, and it's going to take me a little while to get used to this, Gene.
Well, I know people from Rayford wouldn't want to claim him with that color.
No, sir. You don't see that color walking around the streets of Rayford too often. Colt Steele.
Come on, Brad.
Says his determination is to find himself a suitable partner and win the North American Wrestling Association tag team title, which, as you know, a tournament is being planned for the very near future. And some of the tournament matches may be coming to a town near you, so keep your eyes on the newspapers, television, and radio for information as to when the North American Wrestling Association is coming to your town.
Colt Steele's a very vicious wrestler. One thing about him, he has a lot of intensity, and that's one thing you need as a professional wrestler.
Well, you talk about intensity, Gene. We've talked many times about the eyes. Take a look at the eyes of Colt Steele. I've compared him to Charles Manson in the past. He came here to play tonight. Brian Johnson trading punches with Brad Anderson in the middle of the ring, and I think Anderson got the better of the exchange. Into the ropes, neck trouble, catches him coming off the ropes.
The velocity coming off the ropes, it about doubles your speed when you hit those ropes going in at 50 miles an hour. You come out fast as you can go, and that elbow just knocks you to the ground.
I didn't do well in physics, but I know that when you hit a big guy like that, it hurts.
It hurts.
It definitely hurts. Colt Steele into the ring against Brian Johnson, the Carolina connection of Eisley and Johnson. Colt Steele flailing away right now. into the turnbuckles. Nice sunset flip. Nice reversal. Johnson has him for the count of one. Oh, no, that's angered him. See, that's angered. That has angered Coach Steele.
A good wrestling maneuver by Brian Johnson. Coach Steele, though, as you saw, up and ready to go. That's what you need is quickness.
Working on that arm. Brad Anderson into the ring in the gold trunks. Anderson applying the pressure and a boot as well.
If you notice, Ted, they keep working on one area of the body. That is a tradition in the Anderson plan.
No doubt about it. They find the weak man and go after it.
Do you notice the boots that Brad's got on right now?
Yep.
That reminds me when I was growing up watching Gene and Ole Anderson.
Ho-ho! There's one that would have gone 45 yards in the NFL. Nice boot to the face. Isley flailing away right now. And Coach Steele, who made the tag. Nice elbow to the side of the head. Anderson into the ring, and Isley says, I've got some for you. Boy, Ron West has got his hands full, Gene.
He's cleared the ring, David Isley, saying Carolina Connection's going to do their job.
And listen to the crowd. The crowd making no mistakes as to who they're behind today. We're in Raleigh, and we got a great house out here tonight. Ron West getting the count. The legal man in the ring right now is Colt Steele.
Well, Colt just slipped back under the ropes, broke the count. He's back out again. That's a smart wrestler.
Yes, he is. He is the legal man into the ring, and he is the guy that's going to have to go in there when they resume unless he makes the tag. Colt Steele and Brad Anderson talking it over right now. I'd keep my eye on Brad Anderson right now if I were David Isley. Boot to the section. Pounding to the back of the head. David Isley right now going into the bad corner there. Belting that head into the turnbuckle. And you know, Gene, they look padded, but there is steel underneath there.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. I know the bumpers on some cars are padded, but if you let that car hit you, it'll knock you down.
It will hurt. Look at the eyes.
A side chin lock on David.
Look at the eyes on Colt Steele. We were talking, if we can get a close-up on those eyes, you'll see what I'm talking about. You talk about intensity and a guy who is focused. Body slam. Colt Steele coming down with the elbow and catching him on the right shoulder. Going for the pin. One, two. Isley powers out at the count of two.
But David's not ready to give it up right now. He wants to fight to the last minute. This is his chance to move up that run.
Tremendous competitor, this David Isley. Tell you what, if you come out here to pound him, you better bring your lunch because that's going to be an all-day job.
That's right. David Isley doing everything he can to keep the fight in there.
Brad Anderson, who had been wrestling under a hood, we called him the Viper. And then he ran into War Eagle, Chris Chavis. And Chavis says, let's get a close look at who lies underneath that hood. And boy, were we surprised to see the face of young Brad Anderson. Trying to break the hold. Isley working on that midsection, but I'll tell you right now that Anderson's in pretty good shape. Nice! Count of two. Ron West says he didn't get the pin. Anderson pounding away to the back of the head.
David needs a tag right away.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does. He needs to go to that first Brian Johnson. Tag is made. Tag is made. Anderson directing Colt Steele. Trust me, he needs no direction.
Gave him too much time.
Too much time there. And now here comes Brian Johnson to deliver the mail. Off the ropes. Nice.
Good back.
Body slam. Now we've got Foreman in the ring at the same time. And it's target practice with Brian Johnson. But wait a minute. Wait a minute. The referee trying to clear the ring is concentrated on David Isley. And now we're seeing double trouble working on Brian Johnson.
That's totally illegal in the NAWA.
No doubt about it. Uh-oh. We've seen this one before.
Brian's hurt.
Brian is hurt, and this one could be all over. Two, three, this match belongs to Brad Anderson and Colt Steele. And we could be seeing a new combination here. Colt Steele had told us he was shopping for a guy that was as vicious and mean as he was to enter the North American Wrestling Association Tag Team Tournament, and he may have found one in Brad the Viper Anderson. Let's look at the replay, Gene.
I tell you what, as meanness is what you want, Anderson has got it in the blood. They've already double-teamed Brian. He picks up Brian, stands him straight up, straight to the back. That'll knock the wind right out of you. 1, 2, 3.
In addition to jarring that central nervous system, and that they did, this match belongs to Anderson and Steele. When we come back, as it's tag team championship tournament, and I have asked some friends of mine to come up here to get their thoughts on it. War Eagle, Chris Chavis, Bo Reagan, and of course Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. And I'll start with you, Chris. Your thoughts on this as far as entering it as a single or with a partner?
Well, singly, I'm ready. I've been training. I'm ready to compete in the tournament. As far as tag team partners, I mean, we got two of the best right here. You got Ricky, you got Bo. I'd be glad to be with these two guys, and I'm ready to go, just like these guys are.
Bo, your thoughts?
Hey, I'm ready for anything and everything, and I tell you what, we're on top of the world right now, and we're going to take it to wherever we got to beat to get those straps, no matter what combination.
Ricky, as you know, you've worn straps for the WWA, the WWF, the NWA. You've worn more straps than anybody I know of. There's a lot of people that are setting their eyes on you, feeling that if they can beat you, that certainly would be a feather in their cap, as well as a psychological victory over you. This has to keep you up at nights.
Well, you know, anytime that thought comes across my mind, obviously it keeps me on my toes. But I think the biggest thing here tonight is I would like to say hello to all the people here in Raleigh, right here at Dorton Arena. We're bringing it back to the way it used to be. We're bringing it back to make everybody feel good about wrestling. Bring it back each week that everybody can come back out here and hoot and holler and scream and just have a good time and bring some of that good old hometown wrestling back. I want to be a world champion again. I'd love to have each one of these guys as a tag team partner to wear the tag team championship belts again. As many people in this area know, I've had some great matches right here in Raleigh, North Carolina, and I am not too old or washed up to stop that. I've come back for one reason, and that is to wrestle for everybody here, whether you like me or not, because we come here to wrestle and bring it back to the way we want to bring it back, and I'm sure everybody agrees to that.
Well, I tell you what, they certainly love what you're saying tonight, Ricky. You know, when we talk about bringing it back to the Carolinas, there's a lot of big names in professional wrestling that have heard about the tournament that's coming up. They have contacted the promoters locally and are going to be coming in to challenge you. You guys welcome one and all?
Oh, we welcome everyone. We're ready. Look at us. We're ready.
Anybody in particular that you've got your eyes on, Bo?
Hey, bring them all, because if we beat them all, nobody can say anything. And I'm telling you something, we got each other and we got these people behind us.
We'll take a breather and we'll be back after these messages.
245 pounds from Jackson, Mississippi, Alan Kinsey. His partner weighing 240 pounds from Columbia, South Carolina, Sammy Morton.
Successful Steamboat Gym in Charlotte, North Carolina, teaming up with a newcomer to the North American Wrestling Association, Chris War Eagle Chavis. And into the ring, right off the bat, is Alan Kinsey. And Kinsey is wasting no time going to work on Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Off the ropes, catches him with a nice elbow. Kinsey, firing away. Your referee is Byron Richard, calling for the break, and of course, it was just
a stick and a hornet's nest, you're going to get stunned.
And Kinsey is stunned. War Eagle into the ring. Suplex. course, not executed exactly the way that War Eagle wanted it. But Kinsey tried to counter it. Nice elbow to the side of the face. Kinsey right now is stunned. I'll tell you right now, those legs are a little wobbly. How would you like to have that land on your throat?
It's a big man, a lot of power. You see, he's been in the gym, he's been working out with the weights.
Big thighs, full force coming down on the line. So now those head going into the turnbuckles. The tag is made into the ring. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, both men throwing Kinsey into the ropes. Boy, if Kinsey's got an aspirin on him, he better pull it out now. Those punches seem to lack authority, though.
Caught Ricky a little off guard there. There's his partner slow to come in. That might be a mistake right there on their part.
Well, they're giving him enough time to recuperate. Sammy Martin into the ring now. Sammy Martin applying pressure to the wrist. Nice takedown by Ricky Dragon. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
He'll duck under the arm and do a drop toe hold. He's got him where he wants him to hammerlock.
Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, the favorite of a former NFL wide receiver by the name of... Double drop kick, and Sammy Martin in trouble. A fellow that was a wide receiver all-pro for the Miami Dolphins and San Francisco 49ers, who happens to be a native of Gaffney, South Carolina, Freddie Solomon. He's a regular viewer on the show, and his favorite is Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Tell you what, Sammy Martin in trouble right now.
Sammy is looking for a way out.
War Eagle. Full thrust on the lower back. Look at Martin. Martin's not sure where he's at. He's in the Carolina somewhere, but he couldn't give you an exact location right now.
I don't even know if he was in the Carolinas.
He may not. Tell you what, they're working on him right now. Ricky Steamboat. Nice neck breaker. And that could be it. That could be it for Sammy Martin. You know, in addition to hurting the neck, he landed square on the back of the head, Gene.
That's right. It could not give him a little bit of a little consciousness and everything.
He's got him up for a full body slam. Martin right now just about out of gas. And I tell you what, it's not that... Oh, on the side of the head. Nice knee to the side of the head. It's not that Ricky the Dragon Steamboat is sadistic, but I think what he's doing right now is sending out a message to the likes of Big Bob Orton and Baron Samedi and Colt Steele.
All them guys.
And Brad Anderson.
In fact, they probably need two or three messages.
War Eagle making the tag with Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Boom! Body slam. Here comes Ricky off the rope. 235 pounds from about 8 feet up in the air, square on the midsection, of Sammy Martin. Got him up in the air. Boom! Well, I'll tell you right about now, I would say that Mr. Martin is primed for that 1-2-3 count. But they're continuing to administer the punishment. And like I said, this is not their typical style, but I do believe they're trying to send a message to someone, Gene.
Well, when you're in the ring and you're in this business, it's like anything else. A football team could have a score. They're trying to send a message out to everybody that we're here to play.
And they're here to play tonight, I'll tell you that. You don't see Alan Kinsey in any hurry trying to get into the ring.
I thought so. Alan tried to step down and get out of here. But
yeah.
Applying a nice hold on there.
Tying him up into the ring ropes. He's getting instructions right now from Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
The best thing about tag team wrestling, your mind may be thinking one thing, but your partner might have a better idea. He relays it to you.
Got to communicate, too. They've got to stay in constant touch with each other.
You know, these guys have not been wrestling together that much. They are not a tag team per se. They are a tag team now and trying to become a better tag team.
Now, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Well-known, well-respected all over the world. Firing away. Sammy Martin finds himself in a pin. Oh. I don't believe Sammy got out of that. I think Ricky let him go. Just
and
to
Ricky just rolled over and gave him a little surprise there.
He's trying to figure out what is it with Ricky tonight and War Eagle Chris Chavis. Nice chop to the side of the throat. Look at Kinsey. Kinsey has turned spectator.
He's over there saying, keep going, don't tag me, is what he's trying to tell his partner.
You're doing great. That was a mistake you would usually see Ricky make. I think Ricky underestimated how hurt Sammy Martin was. Uh-oh. Now Kinsey's in a hurry to get into the ring, and he does. Nice play. Going over going for the cover. One, two, Ricky Powers out at the count of two.
Go, Ricky!
Alan Kinsey right now taking advantage of a stunned Ricky Steamboat. He didn't want any part of Steamboat a couple of seconds ago.
Kinsey, of course, firing away, hoping that partner doesn't come.
Byron Richard calling for the count. Kinsey firing away while Sammy Martin is holding on. War Eagle trying to get into the ring, and now he's occupied the attention of Byron Richard. His partner's getting beat up at the other corner. Uh-oh. Boy, Ricky is stuck. Come on, Chris. Get outside the ropes. Help him out a little bit. Snapman takedown.
If you're going to come in the ring, you've got to go for your partner and help him. You can't just stand there.
That was pure instinct. That was pure instinct, what you saw Ricky Steamboat do.
If people knew about amateur wrestling and everything, they know that move right there is a basic move. When you're in trouble, you try to sit out.
That is twice that Steamboat has been caught with that boot, and that leads me to believe that Steamboat is hurt right now, Gene.
Let's go, Rick.
That boot is starting to take its toll on Ricky. Ricky's got to come up with something.
He reverses it. He reverses it, makes the tag, and War Eagle now into the ring, firing away right now on Sammy Martin.
Trying to get him up there.
And anytime you see that war dance, you know that the end can't be far away.
He's calling all his spirits and friends.
Nice power slam off the ropes, hits the leg. This could be it for Sammy Martin. It is. This match belongs to Ricky the Dragon Steamboat and War Eagle Chris Chavis. Nice maneuver. And as I told you, when you see that dance, the end can't be far behind. Let's take a look at this on our slow motion instant replay, Gene, and describe the action.
He shoots him off. Oh, nice power slam. Goes to covering. He called on all his ancestors from the Indian tribes. One, two, three.
And there you have it. The winners of this match. War Eagle, Chris Chavis, and his partner, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Stay tuned because the association, the International World Heavyweight Champion, Mark Fleming. Welcome to the Carolinas, Mark.
Oh, I'm so excited to be here in the North American Wrestling Association. I'm ready to wrestle all comers. I won the International World Heavyweight title here in the States. I've been traveling to Japan, Australia, defending my title, and I'm so happy to be here and give anybody a shot here at this title. I'll be glad to do it in a squared circle.
I'm going to tell you what, there's a lot of tradition that goes with that championship belt, and you know what I'm talking about.
Yes, sir, I do. Six-time world champion Lou Thesz held this belt. Ed Stringer Lewis, Jim Lundis, all the greats you can think of in the past, true wrestlers, and I am so honored to hold this. And I'm going to do everything and give 150% in defending this belt every time I get in the ring.
Speaking of the living legend, we'd like to welcome him on board right now. Can we have a nice hand for the living legend, Lou Thesz? Champ, it's a pleasure having you here in the North American Wrestling Association.
Well, thank you very much, Ted. I'm very happy to be here. Saw some fine wrestling here tonight. And when you see Mark Fleming go to post, well, I think you're going to see some more of it.
Well, I tell you, he's got a tremendous tradition to uphold by wearing the strap that you held for a long time.
Well, he won in the tournament, and it belongs to him now, and the championship will be perpetuated on to the next one that beats him. But it'll be interesting to see. It's going to take a great wrestler because I'm mightily impressed with this man's ability. He's a back-to-wrestling movement.
Well, I tell you what, it's a pleasure having you on the program with us this evening.
Thank you so much. Good to be with you. Thank
the
you.
Living legend, Lou Thesz. Boy, that's got to put a little pressure on your back knowing that this guy's in the shadow there and everybody knows about the accomplishments of Lou Thesz. You ever think about that when you go in there to defend the title?
Yes, sir, I do. He watches every move I make, and of course I want to try to impress him, you know? But I'm doing this also for myself and for the people out there because I want to bring back wrestling and show the people what the marquee says is wrestling, and that's what I want to do in the ring.
Well, I tell you, you are one of many that has decided to come back into the Carolinas and join us in the North American Wrestling Association. Competition's revving up. I can't wait to see it happen.
Oh, I'm excited about it. Hey, I'm ready to go, man. I am excited.
The next contest of the evening, weighing 220 pounds from Washington, D.C., to my right here is Lynn Wagner. His opponent to my left, weighing 250 pounds from Kansas City, Missouri, here is Cowboy Bob Orton.
They don't come any tougher, they don't come any meaner than that guy you see right there, Gene.
Cowboy Bob, Kansas City.
Now, when you talk about a sadistic side to a professional wrestler, this man is certainly the personification of sadistic.
When he goes after you, he lets you know that he is there for business.
He's in there with a tough guy by the name of Lim Wagner, and of course, the referee for this event is Ron West. The thing about Bob Orton Jr., Cowboy Bob Orton Jr., is not only can he go downtown, but the guy can flat wrestle, Gene.
He can do it all. His attitude is what destroys his whole, in my opinion, his ability, is because he lets the wrestling go out the door and just wants to hurt somebody.
No doubt about it. He was three-time the state of Florida amateur champion. 3 years running, state of Florida amateur champion. Son of the legendary Bob Orton Sr. And a lot of folks say, you know, there's a tremendous amount of talent in this guy. Why does he have to take the shortcut? And you ask him that question, and he says, because I like it.
That's right. What he wants to do, is he's a selfish individual.
Well, he's certainly going to have the advantage as far as weight, height, and power over Lynn Wagner. Catches Wagner coming off the ropes. Nice hip lock takedown by Lynn Wagner.
Lynn Wagner showing a few of his own moves to Bob Orton.
And Orton into the turnbuckle. And Orton hit that turnbuckle with the midsection, and he is stunned, Gene. Orton taking the shortcut right there, popping a right to the jaw of Lynn Wagner.
Well, I really can't blame him on that. The wind's knocked out. All you got left is a good short right.
Well, we heard that one from here. You could feel that slug to the side of the face. Ted Webb and Gene Ligon. This is the North American Wrestling Association. And Lynn Wagner eating a little dirt there as Bob Orton Jr. ramming that head into the canvas, slamming the knee off the side of the head.
Oh, right into the ear, causing cauliflower ears. It's a rough one.
Well, not only that, but what it does to the equilibrium. When you pop someone in the ear, Orton dragging him outside the ring. Uh-oh. This is what we're talking about. This is where you see most of your injuries in professional wrestling.
Oh,
man, did you hear that?
Oh. He caught him full foot first.
Square into the throat. Wagner outside of the ring. Uh-oh. There's another one to the forehead. I'll tell you what. I've seen him do it 100 times, and 100 times it makes me equally as sick.
It doesn't change, does it?
Not at all. I mean, styles change, clothing changes, but throughout the year, something that has remained fairly consistent is the tactics of one known as Cowboy Bob Orton. He doesn't just want to beat you, he wants to hurt you.
Well, as you look back on your professional career, you say success breeds success. And what's successful with Bob Orton Jr. is his tactics.
And he's going to keep taking it to the bank. No doubt about it. Orton, who has been teaming up with Baron Samedi, is working alone tonight. His influence has certainly been seen in the Baron as well.
Tremendous. Baron has come a much further along since teaming up with Bob Orton Jr.
I'll tell you what, Ron West won't put up with this. Ron West, certainly one of the most proven referees in professional wrestling in America. And he will go just so far, and after that, he'll give Orton the old DQ.
That's right. He will not take too much.
This should be a nice double wing souple. Oh, chicken wing souple. And you know what's impressive? He didn't leave his feet, Coach.
Well, picked him away up near 6'5", 6'6", whatever Bob might be, and it's a long fall.
That's a long fall. He didn't give an inch on that. Jr., the pride of Kansas City, Missouri, in action on the North American Wrestling Association. And we know what this is about, firing away off the side of the head. Orton taking target practice on Lynn Wagner, setting him up for what we have come to know as the superplex. I want you to notice how high he will have him up for this one. Referee Ron West calling for the break, and whoa! See Ron West raising his hand in victory, and look at the face on Orton. Look at the face on Orton. He enjoyed himself on that one. Bob Orton, the winner. Let us go to that instant replay in slow motion. Gene, describe the action.
Bob Orton Jr. has Lynn Wagner high above the wrestling ring, 6 feet up in the air. Now there's Wagner, 1, 2, 3, falls to the mat.
This match belonging to Bob Orton Jr., and stick around, because coming up next is one of my favorites, the youngster, Vince Torelli, accompanied to the ring with his manager, Paul Jones. This is the North American Wrestling Association.
Now, to answer a lot of questions I've been getting through letters and also different places where I visited and people asked me, what is NAWA? Well, it's a new organization with old timers behind it. I'm talking about people in behind the scenes that have brought you wrestling in this area years ago. You talk about wrestlers like Ricky Steamboat that you'll be seeing, Vince Torelli, Chief War Eagle Chavis, and people ask me, what is it? Well, it's going to be wrestling back like it was. It's going to be you people that were used to for years seeing wrestling in your arenas in your hometown week after week or every 2 weeks or whatever. Well, it's going to be back to those days, and it's going to be wrestling. And you can take it from Paul Jones. When I say wrestling, I mean wrestling. I'm talking about punishing holds. And the reason for this, that I can guarantee it, is because the rules are going to be so strict. And if a wrestler tries to get away with beyond the rules, he's going to be suspended and eliminated from NAWA. Now, I can sit here and I can tell you that you're going to see Vince Torelli, one of the big stars in the future. And I'll do the best of my ability to make him world champion. Then you see other wrestlers like Bob Orton Jr. that I don't like, and I don't care for his type of wrestling, but he's gonna have to stay within the rules. Chris War Eagle Chavis, which is a big star. This man, is, you watch him in the future, and he's a nice guy, and he's somebody that you people can get behind and support 100%. And you know, I don't have to say too much about Ricky Steamboat, you know what he's all about. But these guys, they're champions and they're wrestlers that I would want my kids to be around and to set examples for and to be a role model. So NAWA is wrestling that's coming back to your area and your arenas every week, every 2 weeks, or every 3 weeks. So look for it. It's going to be right here in your local area.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next contest of the evening is a one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the ring at this time, weighing 247 pounds from Charlotte, North Carolina, here is Mike Rex.
Motion picture with Jim Belushi and above all people Michael Keaton, Batman.
All right,
he is he's going to be filming the motion picture in North Carolina. Referee Byron Richard calling for the bell. Mike Rex in the ring against the fella in the white trunks, Vince Torelli. I tell you, I can't say enough about Vince Torelli, Gene.
Vince Torelli, a tremendous athlete, a duck under go behind right there. He's teaching this young man a wrestling lesson right now. A high waist lock, the referee's position, riding him nice and strong.
And I tell you what, if Mike Rex wants to rough it up a little bit, this kid can go downtown. He's been a finalist in the National Badman Competition.
And
so needless
is
to say, he's bad.
There he goes, got a nice arm leg cradle.
There's Paul Jones. Well, Paul Jones has got an eye for talent, I'll tell you.
Oh, he sure does. This man right here has got all the talent he ever wants.
No doubt about it.
He can go as far as he wants in this sport.
Torelli. Torelli, who has lost about 15 pounds over the last couple of weeks, said he wanted to trim down and see if he could add a little more speed. I said, you got to be kidding me. That's like adding more speed to a greyhound. Why do you want to do that? Well, he said he did it on the advice of Paul Jones. And as you can see, Paul Jones has his ear. Both men in the middle of the ring, collar and elbow. Into the ropes. Referee Byron Richard didn't even get a chance to call for the break. Nice! You've got your work cut out for you, buddy.
Let me tell you something, Ted Webb, and all these ignorant redneck morons from North Carolina, South Carolina, Virginia, you couch potatoes, the only good thing you have going for you is right here, the Nasty Boys, the class and the flash of professional wrestling. Get out, dig it, baby. Let me tell you another thing. Ricky Steamboat and War Eagle or whoever the hell wants to go against us. Come on, Daddy. Stand in line because we'll knock you right down. Tell them, Fag. Shut your mouth.
You got these two idiots running around here calling themselves the American Bulldogs. They got chains around their necks and they're running around like two jerks. You must feel like losers like the rest of these miserable people standing here in front of me. If they just keep their mouths shut and listen to what we got to say, we might enlighten them a little bit with what's going on around here.
And another thing I want to tell you, Ted Webb, is when we come out to the arena, I want these stinking rednecks and these stinking couch potatoes to stand up because we are the very best.
Well, there you have it. The Nasty Boys, we're about all out of time. We'll see you again next week with Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.